Good morning, all of you. Hope you have gone through the last topic. Let us continue with the rest of our portions with a quick recap. Matrix multiplication we have discussed, and it is not commutative, AB not equal to BA. And we have discussed regarding the transpose. Transpose properties. First one was A transpose whole transpose is equal to A. KA whole transpose is equal to K into A transpose. A plus B whole transpose is equal to A transpose plus B transpose. And symmetric and skew symmetric matrix. What are symmetric matrix? If you are taking the transpose, if you are getting the original matrix itself, that is called symmetric matrix. If you are taking the transpose of the original matrix, if you are getting negative of the given matrix, we are getting skew symmetric matrix. Children, bring your notebook and we can start with the today's portion, that is two theorems related to symmetric and skew symmetric matrix. And we'll discuss one question, represent the given matrix as the sum of symmetric and skew symmetric matrix. It's a usually asking board question, 3-mark question that we will discuss. Then after that we'll discuss about 6 transformations on matrices. Row transformations, 3 row transformation and 3 column transformations. Let us continue our portion. Theorem 1. For any square matrix capital A with the real number entries, A plus A dash is a symmetric matrix and A minus A dash is a skew symmetric matrix. So what is the explanation of theorem 1? If you are taking a matrix A and its transpose, if you are adding both transpose and the real matrix, the resultant matrix will be symmetric matrix. And the same way, if you are taking a matrix A and its transpose and subtract A minus A dash, if you are doing, we will get a skew symmetric matrix. Then theorem 2 is, any square matrix can be expressed as the sum of a symmetric and a skew symmetric matrix. So we have seen in theorem 1, if you are taking a matrix and A and its transpose, and if you are adding, we will get a symmetric matrix. And if you are subtracting a matrix and its transpose, we will get a skew symmetric matrix. So whenever we are getting a question, usually we are getting a question like express a matrix as the sum of a symmetric and a skew symmetric matrix. This is a usual question. It's coming for 3-mark question. So while the question is coming, you can express capital A as half into A plus A dash plus half into A minus A dash. See, A plus A dash is a symmetric matrix. A minus A dash is a skew symmetric matrix. If you are multiplying with a scalar, then also this side is a symmetric matrix and this side is a skew symmetric matrix. See, A dash and minus A dash will cancel. A plus A 2A, if you are having half, it will cut and will get reach as A itself. So whenever we are getting a question of this type, first we have to find out its transpose, find out A plus A dash and multiply with half and make it as equation number 1. That is a symmetric matrix. And the other one, find A minus A dash and multiply with half. That portion is skew symmetric matrix. If you are adding both, we will get the same matrix itself. While you are getting this type of question, our first step is find half into A plus A dash. And the second step is find half into A minus A dash. And if you are adding both, we will get the same matrix itself. That is the solution of this question. Let us start. First, name it as a matrix B is equal to the given matrix. So B dash, we will find out its transpose. First, B dash is equal to, what is the transpose? First, we have to write the first column as the first row. B transpose is equal to matrix 2 minus 1, 1. First column, we will write as first row.
Then we will write the second column as second row, minus 2, 3, minus 2. And we will write the third column as third row, minus 4, 4, minus 3. Our next step is find half into B plus B dash. We will name it as P. That is equal to half into B plus B dash. We will add the given matrix and its transpose. 2 plus 2, 4. Then minus 2 minus 1, minus 3. The same way we have to add the rest of the elements also. Minus 3, 6, 2, minus 3, 2, minus 6. This is half into B plus B dash. We express as P. And we have to multiply with half. We are getting the answer as 2 minus 3 by 2 minus 3 by 2 minus 3 by 2 3 1 minus 3 by 2 1 minus 3. This is the first part. So next is half into B minus B dash. Take the transpose and we have to subtract it. Name it as Q. Q is equal to half into B minus B dash. While you are doing B minus B dash, we are getting matrix 0, minus 1, minus 5, 1, 0, 6, 5, minus 6, 0. Children, you are supposed to do these questions along with this explanation in your notebook. Then this is equal to half into 0, 0. Half into minus 1, minus 1 by 2, minus 5 by 2, half into 1, 1 by 2, 0, 3, 5 by 2, minus 3, 0. So we got the second section, Q is equal to half into B minus B dash. First we got half into B plus B dash, equation number 1, that was symmetric part, and half into B minus B dash, the second part, that is Q symmetric part. So we can represent as the sum of two matrices, P plus Q is equal to, the first answer was 2 minus 3 by 2 minus 3 by 2 minus 3 by 2 3 1 minus 3 by 2 1 minus 3. That was P plus Q. The thing what we got it as equation number 2, 0 minus 1 by 2 minus 5 by 2 1 by 2 0 3 5 by 2 minus 3 0. So if you are adding this one, we are getting as 2 into 2 plus 0, 2 is the given matrix itself. 2 minus 2, 4 minus 1, 3, 4 1 minus 2, minus 3. Check it as, check this matrix. This is same as the given matrix B. So B is expressed as the, so we have expressed the given matrix as the sum of symmetric and skew symmetric matrix. This is the solution. Now you can go through the exercise 3.3. The main questions I'm giving as assignments. You can go through all the questions which are really simple questions in the beginning. And these are the types of questions important. 10th question, 2nd and 3rd one, 3 by 3 matrix of the same type what we have discussed now. 7th and 9th, 6th questions also. These are a little bit different. All the questions you can go through. These are different type of questions. Next is elementary operations of a matrix. We have 6 elementary operations or transformations on a matrix. 3 are due to rows and 3 are due to columns. First one is the interchange of any 2 rows or 2 columns are possible. Like the first row can be shifted to second row. The same way second row can be shifted to first row. Likewise you can change any row. Interchange you can do. Then the same way you can do in the case of column also. First column can be interchanged second column. Second column can be interchanged to first column. The same way second and third or first or third you can do. The second property is the multiplication of elements of any row or column by a non-zero number. See, if you are taking the first row itself, the full elements of first row can be multiplied with a scalar. So first row, if you are taking, we can multiply all the elements in a row with the 2 or 3. Any scalars you can multiply. The same way, the column also you can do. You take any one of the column, there you can multiply with the scalar. That also possible. The third one is the addition to the elements of any row or column, the corresponding elements of any other row or column multiplied by any non-zero number. You can refer page number 90 of your textbook. The addition to the elements of any row or column, the corresponding elements of any other row or column multiplied by any non-zero number. That is, if you are taking the first row, we can add with the first row plus 2 into second row. Second row elements you multiply with 2, that can be added with the first row. The same with column also we can do. First column plus any scalar into second element. These are all things we can do, and with one example, we can verify this properties. So we'll verify each of the properties with an example. First, I told that we can interchange the rows. The first example we can take it as matrix 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. This is A. We can take it as A. So first we can interchange any row. Here I am changing the first row and second row. See, this is the second row and this is the first row. So it is possible to change R1 and R2. We are interchanging. So second row became first row here. 4, 5, 6, and the first row became second row, 1, 2, 3. This type of transformation is possible. This is the first type of operation. And the same way we can change the column also. Here 1, 4, 7 and 2, 5, 8, we can interchange both the columns. Or 1 and 3 you can change, or 2 and 3 you can change. If you are changing the second column to third one, third column will become the second column. The same way, we can do any column or any row. That is the interchange of any two rows or two columns. This is the first type of operation. This is row transformation and the other one is column transformation. Then we will discuss regarding the second property. Second operation. So, that is that means if you are taking one particular row, we can multiply with a scalar. See, take the first example, same example, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So, I am going to multiply the first column with a scalar 2. 1, 4, 7 was the first column of the matrix. So, we will multiply with the 2. We are getting 2 into 1, 2, 2 into 4, 8, 2 into 7, 14. The rest of the elements are keeping like that itself. We are changing the first column, multiply with the scalar and writing, no change will be there. This is the second type of transformation. This can be done in the first row also. If you are taking the elements 1, 2, 3, that also can be multiplied with K or P or anything. Any scalar can multiply. That can be done in with any row or any column. That is the second type of elementary operation. And we move on to the third type. There we are taking first row plus a scalar, apply this number with a scalar. So we can write it as R1 becomes R1 plus 2R2. So take the same example, 1, 2, 3. This is the first row, 1, 2, 3. We are adding, multiplying the second row with the 2, all the elements of second row with the scalar 2, and we are adding with the first row. So, if you are multiplying with 2, 2 into 4, 8, 8 plus 1, 9. The same way, 2 into 5, 10, 10 plus 2, 12. Then 2 into 6, 12 plus 3, 15. The rest of the rows will be remaining like that itself. This is the row transformation, third type. The same way we can do for column also. Any row you can take, that one will be multiplied with a scalar and add with the other row. That can be done in column also. These are the six elementary operations on the matrices.